Hour is defined as the time derivative of work, p equals to du over dt. And since du equals to the dot product of the force vector and the position vector dr, therefore power equals to the dot product of the force and dr dt. And we learned from kinematics already that dr dt is the time derivative of position, which is the instantaneous velocity. Therefore, power is simply the dot product of the force vector and the velocity vector. And again, since the dot product of two vectors is a scalar, power is always a scalar, just like work or energy. Since the unit of work in the SI unit system is joule, therefore the unit for power in the SI unit system is joule per second or watt. In the US customary system, the unit for power is foot pound per second, or a more common unit is horsepower. 1 horsepower equals to 550 foot pound per second, and 1 horsepower equals to 746 watt. The efficiency of a machine is defined as the power output divided by the power input. For example, we know that an electrical motor will convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. Therefore, its efficiency is determined as the mechanical power it generates divided by the electrical power supplied to this motor. And since there's always energy loss during energy conversion, therefore the efficiency is always smaller than 1. Let's look at this example. We have a 50 kilogram uniform crate initially resting on this inclined surface. The coefficients of both static and kinetic friction between the crate and the surface are given. Then there's a force that starts to pull this crate. The force is a function of time, and we need to determine the power output developed by the force at t equals to 6 seconds. The strategy is really simple, because the instantaneous power equals to force times velocity. Therefore, all we need to do is to find out when t equals to 6 seconds, what is the magnitude of the force and what is its velocity, and the power simply equals to f times v. However, here's a twist. Because when this force starts to pull this crate, the crate will not start moving simultaneously. Instead, it will stay at rest until the maximum static frictional force has been overcome. Therefore, we will need to first determine how long does it take for this crate to start moving under this force. So we start this problem with, again, free body diagram of this crate showing all external forces, and we choose the x-axis of our coordinate system conveniently to be along this inclined surface pointing up. Before motion starts, we apply equations of equilibrium instead of the equations of motion. So the resultant force along the x direction equals to 0, and the resultant force along the y direction also equals to 0. From these two equations, we can solve for the normal force and the maximum frictional force of static friction is evaluated by mu s times n to be 84.96 newton. And from equilibrium, we can determine at this point, the applied force is 330.2 newton, which equals to 40t plus 200. T is the time in second. Therefore, from here, we can solve for the time to be 3.255 second. So this is when the crate will start moving. So now motion has already started. Along the y direction, there's still no motion, but along the x direction, we apply the equation of motion, which is the resultant force along the x direction equals to mass times ax, the acceleration along the x direction. From here, we can solve for ax to be a function of time as well. According to kinematics, this also equals to dv dt. Therefore, at t equals to 6 seconds, we can evaluate the magnitude of the applied force, but we can also evaluate the velocity of this crate from kinematics. and that equals to 4.178 meter per second. Therefore, at this point, the power generated by this force equals to the magnitude of the force times the velocity of the crate to be 1.84 kilowatt.